Welcome to the Salem News Softball Video Pad Podcast. I am Salem News writer Matt Jenkins, and with me here is the softball guru, Mike Grenier. We're here for our first podcast of the season, so there's obviously a lot to talk about. Some teams are almost halfway through their schedule at this point, believe it or not, even with the weather we've had. But Mike, let's get off, you know, right off the bat here and just talk about maybe some teams who have surprised a little bit in the early season. Who are these teams that we need to watch out for?
Well, it's funny, first of all, Matt, that you should mention about some teams are halfway through the schedule, and yet other teams have only played four or five games because of the weather or wet fields and all that stuff. And they're going to be, in a way, that hurts them because they'll be playing catch-up, playing three or four times per week, as opposed to other teams that might play just two or three times per week. So with that out of the way, I'd like to talk about three teams that did not make the state tournament last year who are making a hard push already to get back to the postseason. Number one would be Bishop Fenwick. You know, last couple of years, they've fallen just a game or two short. And Paul Lyman, the head coach, and I know the kids, they were upset by just missing it by one or two games. This year, they were off to a 7-0 start. They've won the close games that they would lose in previous years. You know, they've beaten some very good Catholic Central League teams, such as Archbishop Williams Arlington Catholic, and Cardinal Spelman as well. And so they're off to a 7-0 start, so they're flying high right now. They don't want to take anything for granted at this point, but they're getting tremendous pitching from senior Taylor Ahern, who has a very low earned run average, somewhere about 1.20. Meredith Ross is leading the attack, along with other kids. They have a good balanced offense. So that's one team that obviously is 70% of the way there in terms of qualifying for the state tournament, and they haven't lost yet. So they built up a nice little cushion. To me, Fenwick has been a big surprise, but to me, I think Beverly has been an even bigger surprise because, you know, last year they were a disappointing team, and no one really knew how they were going to do this year. But Coach Megan Sudak has really revived the team, and they're building some confidence, and they've done it with health issues. Right now, Beverly's 5-1. They beat a very good Salem team earlier this week. They beat a great pitcher in Salem, Sarah Chassie, in a 2-1 game. Their first loss they suffered today against an undefeated Lynn Classical team. But right now they're sitting at 5-1. They have a lot of confidence in themselves. And when I mentioned health issues, well, Sarah Pizzullo was the projected, you know, returning pitcher, and she tore her ACL. And it's just about getting back to pitch. So in the interim, senior Rachel Wilworth has done a phenomenal job. Here's a kid who pitched maybe one or two games last year and played a little bit of outfield, kind of as a spot starter. Really didn't get much playing time on the varsity last year. But she's taken the steps to, you know, in the offseason to improve herself. And she became the number one pitcher this year. And she pitches with a lot of confidence, a lot of ability, and a lot of composure. And she's won some close games already this season. And, you know, she's just a great student, too. I mean, literally in the classroom, she has like a 4.5. I think she's a National Merit Scholar. And I think she uses that cerebral or intelligent way of approaching the game, and she's been just absolutely great so far. And I think right now Coach Sudak has a, like what you call a pleasant problem, in the sense that with Pizzullo coming back, you know, she has two pitchers as go-to kids. You know, she can pitch them against anybody all season, and they'll probably get a 1-2 pitching punch and, you know, be in good shape for the postseason. I think they're doing great. And the third team that missed the state tournament last year that's doing well this year would be Marblehead. You know, they have a veteran pitcher in Sarah Hastings, but they also have a freshman who is just coming to the forefront, pitched against Masco in a 3-1 win last week. And her name is Michaela LeBlanc, and probably she might do a little bit of pitching here and there. So the Marblehead Magicians are 5-3 at this point with a pending game against undefeated Lynn Classical coming up. So those three teams so far have done a tremendous job of launching themselves off into a great start to position themselves to make the state tournament. And, you know, it makes for an exciting season when those teams that, you know, were not quite there last year are getting there this year.
You mentioned so many pitchers in that, you know, little segment there, Mike, and it got me thinking, you know, softball, maybe of all the sports that we cover, you know, that one position, pitcher in softball is the one position of all the sports that we cover that can really carry a team. So, I mean, when we look at our local teams this year, are those the players right now that are, you know, among the individual players who have really been dominating so far, is it primarily pitchers so far?
There's no question. I think pitching is, like you mentioned, in softball, it's so different than baseball, of course, because of the different arm motion. You know, pitchers can literally go 20 to 25, 26 games per season. And that's why Salem, you know, which, again, is on a path to make this tournament this year, the state tournament this year, with Sarah Chassie. And Sarah Chassie is now a senior. She's a four-year starter, basically. She's won a lot of games over the years. And she's having another tremendous season. I think she went through a four-game stretch where she had like two or three one-hitters and a two-hitter, and Salem built a four-game winning streak around that. And she's dangerous. Anytime she takes the mound to shut you down, she can shut down anybody. Although I have to hand it to Beverly the other night, they scrapped out two runs. They manufactured a couple of runs against Sarah Chassie and won that big game 2-1. But Salem right now, at this point, is sitting at 4-2 and is on its way to making the state tourney again, hopefully, under Coach Dan Bertone. But Sarah's a dominating pitcher. Danvers is a very interesting team this year from the pitching standpoint because they have all kinds of hitters. I mean, they've scored, I believe, 47 runs in five games. And they're only 3-2, however, because they're using some young pitchers. They have two freshman pitchers. Coach Tara Petroselli is grooming two freshman pitchers to carry the load this year. And she's very patient with them, and the hope being that by the end of the season, they've won enough games to build confidence in both those young freshmen and then carry that into the postseason. So they're not panicking over there in Danvers, even though they've lost a couple of games early in the season. But they have a phenomenal offense with the Danvers Falcons. And you have a lot of veterans, Gabby Vega at shortstop. You have Alicia Dean, a four-year player. You have Logan Carabello. You have Sam DiBella behind the plate. She had a home run earlier today. So they have a lot of veterans, a lot of offense. And, of course, to help that pitching, you also have veteran solid defense. So therefore, you know, the pitchers don't have that pressure of having to maybe try to win a game 1-0 or 3-2. The Falcons can score a lot of runs, and that's going to help in the long run with building the young pitchers' confidence.
Mm-hmm. No, Mike, to put you on the spot a little bit here then, if you could start a team right now with our local players,
yes,
would you start with a pitcher, and who would it be?
I think I'd probably go with Sarah Chassie, the Salem pitcher, because she's become almost an automatic W, or at least if not an automatic W, she's going to keep you in the game, even if the defense is not playing all that well, because she's a strikeout artist. She can strike out a lot of kids. And actually, I'm not trying to say that Salem has a bad defense. In fact, they have a very good defense, led by Julia Jennings, a senior who's been a four-year player. But if the defense is having an off day, Sarah Chassie, the type of kid to come back and, you know, if it's a four-out inning, a five-out inning, because of an error or two, she can come back and strike out the side. So, yeah, I would probably start my team with Sarah Chassie. And then behind the plate, if I could, you know, take someone from another team, that would probably be Liz Glavin of Ipswich, who's a four-year catcher, who is a powerhouse hitter. And, boy, I tell you, I would like to see that combination because that would be a great battery mate combination to have against any opponent. And, so I'd start with Sarah Chassie, catcher Liz Glavin, and then I guess, you know, we could spend all day comparing, you know, filling in the other positions.
Any chance we could ever see maybe a Sarah Chassie pitching to a Liz Glavin at the plate? And who might have the advantage in that situation?
Oh, I'll tell you what. I don't know. Liz Glavin, I know career-wise, she had her, I think you brought that up, Matt, last week. She had her 100th hit career-wise about a week or so ago. And a tremendous home run threat at every at-bat. And I tell you, that would be a tough matchup. I don't know who I'd flip a coin on that one.
Glavin's 100th hit actually was
a home run. That's right.
Yeah, she's impressive, obviously.
Yeah, there's no question about it. She's a great player. And a lot of great players on the North Shore this year. It's, you know, as the weather warms up, hopefully, we'll get out there and fans can see more games and see some of this. Very competitive. There's a lot of very competitive teams on the North Shore this year. Several, you know, will make the state tournament.
And as the weather warms up, I'm sure our podcast will heat up a little bit, too.
Yeah.
So until next time, I'm Matt Jenkins, and this is Mike Grenier.
It's always a pleasure.